Scripture reading tonight is coming from Psalm 150, And it reads as such, King James states in this wise, praise ye the Lord.
Yeah.
Praise God in his sanctuary.
Yeah.
Praise him in the firmament of his power.
Yeah.
Praise him for his mighty acts. Praise him according to his excellent greatness. Praise him with the sound of the trumpet. Praise him with the psaltery and harp. Praise him with the timbrel and dance. Praise him with stringed instruments and organs. Praise him upon the loud cymbals. Praise him upon high sounding cymbals.
Favor is deceitful and beauty is vain. But a woman that feareth the Lord, she shall be praised. Give her of the fruit of her hands, and let her works praise her in the gates. Let the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. Hide me behind the cross and speak to these claims of mine. And if anybody asks me who did it, I'll be careful to tell them that Jesus did it. As we celebrate on this afternoon, I just simply would tag this text, the lady of the house. Would you look at somebody and say, there's a lady in the house. Ask somebody around you, who is that lady? She is a phenomenal woman. Real ladies are almost extinct now. They're hard to find. When I was growing up, I admired ladies. You all know how the ladies used to be when they would tell you that to put your slip on and they cared about how they looked, and it was something about the lady in the house. Because where I grew up, you could not show up at church any kind of way, because the ladies would just tap you on the shoulder and come over and tell you, you can't do that in here, darling. According to the Urban Dictionary, lady is a title that defines an eloquent, gracious, loving woman who uses etiquette and diplomacy in both the public and private. You see, any female is a woman or can be called a woman, but it takes some work to be a lady. It is an inborn, and it is a practice, a fine art, and takes focus and consideration. There is something special about a lady. You see, you always know who the lady of the house is when you walk in the house. Her touch is reflected in every room. She is in charge even when she's not home. Her influence and presence is everywhere. The way her children look, how her husband looked, people will ask the question, who is the lady of the house? Now, you all look mighty sanctimonious this afternoon, but some of you remember Isley Brothers. Recorded this song in 1973. One of the biggest hits. Who's that lady? A real fine lady. A beautiful lady. You see, the fellas saw this beautiful woman and asked the question, who's that lady? Because there was something about her and they wanted to get to know her. And I asked that question to myself, who's that lady, the lady of the house? And I thought about these phenomenal women that we are celebrating today. And God took these women of distinction and these leading ladies. And the Lord took me to the Proverbs, a real lady. Webster defines phenomenal as being extraordinary, outstanding, and remarkable. What is this phenomenal woman and what does she look like? Our text today is about a familiar woman. The words of King Lemuel, the utterance in which his mother taught him. As a king, a leader, an example to the public, there is a certain type meaning a woman of virtue, a woman that everyone in here would like to be compared to. If we look closely, we will find that this woman is not just an ordinary woman. For the scripture begins with a question, who can find a virtuous woman? Meaning, do you know where she is or where she abides? Someone is looking for a lady. This gives me to know that she is special and rare and unique with an unusual quality. You have to search for her. You see, you can't find her on Baltimore Street. She is scarce, a special kind of lady. She is a lady with value and worth. The text says that she is far more valuable and worth far more than rubies. She is like a rare gem. Precious stones are precious and costly because they are rare. If you can go out along the roadside and collect hundreds of rubies anytime you wanted to, they would not be worth much. It is the rare, hard to find gems that are worth so much. In the fascinating world of gemstones, the ruby is the undisputed ruler. For thousands of years, the ruby has been considered one of the most valuable gemstones on earth. It has everything a precious stone can have: magnificent color, excellent hardness, outstanding brilliance. In addition to that, it is an extremely rare gemstone, especially in its finest qualities. The ruby is a stone of divine creativity. It boosts your energy levels and promotes high self-esteem, intuition, and spiritual wisdom. The ruby is a symbol of good fortune, pure love, and loyalty. It brings vigor into your life. I tell you, a ruby is a rare gem, like a special kind of lady, the lady of the house. The lady of the house is distinctly different. You see, when God created the heaven and the earth, he spoke them into existence. But when he made the woman, he used his hand and fashioned her after himself. He chose the bone that protects man's life, the rib. And around this one bone, he shaped the woman moldly perfectly. You are a beautiful little girl, but now you are a splendid woman of excellence, filled with virtue in your heart. Fashioned in his holiness with strength, purity, and his love. Designed uniquely, sisters, to be the helpmeet of the man of God. God took time when he made you, so we need to handle these gems with care. The lady of the house has integrity and inward beauty. If you read about this phenomenal woman, her beauty has nothing to do with her outward appearance.
Change the exterior, but what's on the inside? She can't.
for the things behind the scenes, so he's free to be everything that God calls him to be. Let me make it plain. The lady of the house, make sure that the socks are matched. And make sure that the bed is changed every day. Make sure that the shirt goes to the cleaners. So when he shows up, all you see is a product of what the lady of the house has worked so hard to do. The text says that he is known as a man of great nobility and great respect because of the contribution that she most unselfishly gives to him. And you can be sure that she's done everything so that her husband can do the things that God has called her to do. Yeah. She is submission, submissive. She is under the mission that God has called her husband to do. I know that people don't like that word, but I'm proud to be a submissive lady of the house. And this woman has surrendered, and I'm out of here. I said that this woman has surrendered. The lady of the house is surrendered to God. She is devoted to God. Nothing else will last in verse 30. Nothing else will last, but a woman that fears the Lord shall be praised. But the fear of God reigning in her heart is the beauty of her soul that will last forever. She reverences God in everything that she does. She realizes that the joy of the Lord is her strength. She lives her life to please God.
Children.
trusting God.
Survive.